Indy Mogul.
Hey Indie Mogulers, Griffin here. If you're confused about why I'm here instead of Russell, that's because we've moved MovieQuest to Fridays. And if you're confused why I'm here instead of Eric Beck, then you really need to start paying attention. Our new three-show programming lineup means you'll see me on Mondays with Indie News, Russell on Fridays with MovieQuest, and Wednesdays is the Awesome Directors Project. And today is the first Wednesday in April, so I'm excited to introduce this month's Awesome Director. His name is Dave Seger, and he's a good friend of mine. We met on Film Fights way back, so he also knows cool people like Justin Johnson. He's an award-winning freelance video producer in Los Angeles and has directed some really cool projects like IKEA Heights, a melodramatic Channel 101 show shot entirely inside an actual IKEA store. He also co-created a complete remake of the 1984 film Footloose, assembling scenes from 58 of his filmmaking friends, including one scene shot by Eric Beck. Dave is also friends with Dan Harmon, the creator of the NBC show Community, and Dave has shot behind the scenes and promotional videos for the show, and even produced Abed's student film in Community's first season. And on Monday, I shared YouTube's April Fool's video. Dave actually makes a quick cameo as the truck driver. I have Dave Seger here on video chat, so we'll learn more about his background and find out what he's working on this month for the Awesome Directors Project. Hey Dave, how are you?
Oh, I'm doing pretty good here in California.
What's kind of going on in your life and career right now?
Lately, I'm a freelance director, so I've been doing a lot of just various freelance gigs. I do a lot of work for a company called Break.com, doing web commercials, and basically, being a freelance director, I just take on anything, any directing or editing or producing related job if I have time for it.
A lot of our audience is kind of curious about how to get into freelance work. I do a lot of freelance work, so do you have any advice for how to find work in the first place?
I guess getting into freelance work, a big part of it is just, one, people trusting your ability so that they're comfortable hiring you. It seems like once with freelance work is once you get that first job and you kind of prove yourself there, then the more opportunities come from the same people or people who see that same thing and want you to do more of that. You know, just keep making stuff for fun. Take any and as many jobs that come your way, because you never know which one's going to link into, you know, doing cooler stuff that's more, you know. So if you're editing a dance video or something like that or a wedding video, you don't know what of that is going to kind of help prove yourself to do other cool stuff.
Yeah, I feel the same way. I do a lot of weddings, and I think that's led to a lot of other business for me. So speaking of doing things for fun, just trying things, and I mean, you and I met through Film Fights, and then you were also pretty active in Channel 101. So can you tell me how important like those kinds of communities are?
Oh, well, that stuff's great, because I was just talking to Justin about this the other night, Justin Johnson. Every single job I've had since I've been in LA, and I've been in LA 5 years, has 95% of them have been through either Film Fights or Channel 101. I did some work on Next New Networks or whatever. Did some work there through Justin. So it's just like, I guess knowing a bunch of people who are doing the same stuff is the best, you know, Channel 101, anything like that, because then those people, you know, if they have too much work or if they know of an opportunity, they've seen your stuff and they trust you enough to say, hey, Dave, why don't you take on this thing? Or hey, Griffin, why don't you take on this thing?
Well, yeah, that's how I got my work, is definitely networking with Justin and Eric and knowing them through Film Fights. And is that how you got to work on Community?
Yeah. The creator of Community, Dan Harmon, actually created Channel 101 with this guy, Rob Schraub, back in 2003. And I was a fan of Channel 101 from before I even moved to California. And so when I moved into town, I immediately hit those guys up and said, is there anything I can do to help? There's voting at the Channel 101 live screenings. I became the person who would like build the ballots, you know, who would update the website and put the new shows on and stuff like that. Just kind of took on all this extra workload just because I loved Channel 101 so much. And that turned into I've worked for both Rob and Dan on a bunch of jobs as their assistants, and them looking at my Channel 101 projects led them to go like, okay, he knows what he's doing as a, you know, he's a good assistant, but he also knows what he's doing as a creator. Hey, why don't you take on this community web project? Or, hey, Dave, we need someone to do Abed's short film. Could you do Abed's short film? Because we don't want it, because the director doesn't want to do it. It's not that the director doesn't want to do it. It kind of was that the director didn't want to do it. And so they just asked me to do this Abed short film.
You do so much freelance work, but you just put out a lot of videos on your own. Like, do you have any idea how many videos you've made in your life?
It's something like 500 videos. Because I was doing like weekly videos for, you know, like 2 years and stuff like that. So I'm sure I have a bunch of... too much. I've done too much. I have too much little... weird things.
Well, that's what I'm excited about this month, is just knowing that you have so much experience because you do so many different things. So do you want to tell us about what you have in mind for a project for the Awesome Directors Project?
I've been getting really into doing music videos lately. I'm a big music fan. I get really excited about new music, and I get really motivated about finding an artist that I want the rest of the world to know about and stuff like that. So I've been sort of, now that I'm, you know, As I have more free time in the freelance world, I've been tinkering with various music videos. I've got a couple in the works, and so for this, I'm starting up another new music video. I'm using this as an opportunity to make a cool music video for this band called Flint Eastwood, who are pretty cool. And yeah, I just want to, their song, I think we're doing it for this song called Rewind, and so we're going to do some reverse motion kind of stuff, and it should be really cool. I'm looking forward to it.
By now, our audience should know what to expect, but can you tell us what they'll be seeing for the next 3 weeks?
There's some specific effects that I'm going to be doing in the video that I want to sort of break down and demonstrate. I don't consider myself an expert on anything. I've been doing this stuff for a while, and I have fun doing it. So I want to try and just like pepper in as much little personal filmmaking philosophies I've learned from doing this stuff, low-budget filmmaking philosophies. I'm going to try and pepper in throughout as much as possible.
Cool. All right, well, I'm going to stop rolling.
Okay, same here.
So join me and Dave Seger next Wednesday when he takes us behind the scenes on his music video production. And at the end of the month, we'll premiere his final video on his channel, so you should subscribe to him right here. And even though he's made a lot of videos, you may notice there's only a few on this channel. That's because he just made this one. It's a secondary channel, but it's the one where his video will premiere. So you should subscribe. Remember, new schedule. Fridays is Movie Quest. Monday is Indie News. And I'll see you all later.
Hey, everyone. Welcome to my new YouTube channel, David Seger Official.
Oh, yeah. It's my new YouTube channel.